Great, thanks very much. As Nick said, I'm Fergus Scully, and I'm Chief Vitals at Google, Cloud Manager. Has anybody here heard of Android Vitals before or used about it? Cool, a few people. The rest of you have heard about it by the talk record. Great, so we're going to go through four different parts of this. First part is why should you care about performance overall? Second is what's the new in Android Vitals for people who have used it before. We'll also cover as part of that what is already there, but pointing out exactly what is new. And then we'll talk about how you can improve specific parts of your application through Core Vitals. And finally, we'll go into how you can learn more about Vitals outside of the Play Console. Okay, the mic seems really weird on my end. Can you guys hear me okay? So when we look at the reviews that Corpus over of the whole Google Play, which includes over a billion written reviews, we found that when we extracted the topics that people were talking about within the one-star reviews, that 40% of the time they're talking about stability bugs. And for every one-star review you get, you need 9 five-star reviews to end up with a 4.5-star average app. So one-star reviews as a result of your app crashing are really, really important to avoid. And then we looked at the five-star reviews. What we find is that the positive aspects of performance are what 70% of the five-star reviews are talking about. And these include speed, design, and usability. But that's just what people are talking about. How about what people are actually doing in that? So what we looked at here is for specific games, where some users have a really high crash rate, some users have a really low crash rate, we looked at the difference in engagement. And what we found is, for users who have a really low crash rate, their engagement with the app was over 2 minutes longer than users with a high crash rate. And what we found for AMRs, which is application not responding, was even more meaningful in terms of the difference between users who have a high versus low experience. Another major reason to take into account quality and performance when you're thinking about VMs is that the Google Play Store actually uses the signals from your app performance as part of the ranking in the store itself. So if you have a low quality app, you won't actually get surfaced in the store in certain parts. So that's thanks to promotability. And we also have featured collections where you get featured at certain places in the store, like new and updated. And we have badges that we provide for the editor's choice. And we also have an award system, mostly related to Google I/O awards for best apps. And all of those use the signals that we have on the quality of apps as a way to be able to determine whether you're eligible. So what is Android Vitals? Android Vitals is Google's program to help developers be able to understand the performance and stability of their applications and help them improve their apps. And since the launch of Google I/O last year, so in May of last year, we've had over 100,000 developers using it regularly. So pretty good adoption so far. And we've seen major actually improvements in the quality of apps in the ecosystem. So this is just showing the number of mentions of that users have in reviews in terms of one-star and five-star for specific issues over the past year. And it's gone up 4% for speed, design, usability, and down close to 20% for stability and bugs and resource usage being battery, memory, etc. When we look at specific partners and the results that they have, we've seen some pretty amazing results across top partners. For example, Netflix reduced their crash rate by over 70% in 3 months. And here we can see Starbucks that has invested heavily in their app performance and has over 10 million installs, so pretty widely used application. And they reduced their AMR rate by 70% and their crash rate by 85%. When we look at the game side of things, we had our first game ever on Google Play reach a billion installs called Subway Surfers. people that we've worked with over the last couple of months to help them use Vitals, and they saw their A&R rate go down by 95%. And as a result, they saw their DAU, so daily active users, increase by 9%. And their number of sessions per user increase as well. So really sizable results for improving the performance here. So now we're jumping into sort of what's actually included in the product. So right now there's five performance areas with Vitals. So battery, stability, rendering, startup time, and permissions. Within battery, we have four metrics that we provide to help you be able to understand how you're doing. And so you can see here the list of them. And so these are sort of proxy metrics to your battery usage. So we don't provide overall battery consumption for your application. We provide these metrics that we know contribute to battery consumption and how many users are being impacted by negative effects of these services. On the stability side of things, we have A&Rs, application not responding, so this is where it takes more than 5 seconds for the app to respond to any input event in foreground. And we have crash rates, where the user receives or experiences one crash in a day. On the rendering side of things, we wanted developers to build fast response apps that don't lag. And here we provide two metrics, frozen frames and slow rendering. Slow rendering is where takes more than 50% of your frames over 60 milliseconds to render on the screen, and frozen frames where 1 in 1,000 frames takes 700 milliseconds to load. On the startup side of things, we have three new metrics that we introduced depending on the state of your application when it was started. So slow cold start being when the app hasn't been used in a while and it's not in memory. Slow warm start when it's in memory. And then slow hot start, where it's been recently used. On the permission side of things, we want apps to only request permissions that provide value to users. And what we see is that users oftentimes don't accept the permission request from developers when developers don't provide a justification for why they need that permission. And so if you're not providing a justification today, I'd really encourage you to do so. And we've seen developers who add the justification have a much higher acceptance rate for permissions. And if you don't see an improvement after adding the reasoning that you think you need that permission, and users are still denying it, it's probably that you maybe should think about, can you offer your service without requesting that permission? Because users aren't willing to do it. We also see a very high denial rate overall for permissions. And so it's worth your while trying to build your app with the expectation that a lot of your users will actually not accept the permission. And so how would you go to offer your core value app without that permission? For each of the permissions, we provide like, a breakdown for across each of the individual permission groups. So camera, contacts, location, storage, etc. Whichever ones you're requesting. Across all the Vitals, we provide many breakdowns. The most common ones for relevant are APK version, device, and Android version. For wavelengths and wavelengths, we provide by tag. For A&Rs, we provide by activity name, by A&R type, and we cluster the A&Rs as well. And the same for crash, we provide clusters there as well. Another thing that we realized over the last year that was really important for developers to understand how insights into how they compare with the apps that are in their category. And we can see here for even these new metrics that we added at I.O., there's a lot of variation across the different categories themselves for slow cold startup time across the different types of games and the permission denial rate across maps and navigation versus books and reference. And you can gain insights into those in the console where you can be able to see for the 25th, 50th, and 75th percentile breakdown. For top apps in the category. And this is what that looks like. So you can see here the percentage of sessions that are impacted across those different percentiles, and then where you stack up versus other apps in the category. on the overview page for Android Vitals, we provide a list of the metrics, and then you can be able to quickly see now with the benchmark section there, where should you actually invest more time in. So here you're in the bottom 12% of Android category for the last one, and so you can click on that to view more details and investigate it. What we found is by giving this information in the Play Console, is that we've changed the dynamic within app companies for talking about performance and prioritizing what to invest in. Because now the whole leadership team has access to the performance information about the application. So in the past, the developer who was working on the application would be in Android Studio and be able to profile the application and be able to understand, okay, actually it's doing badly here, and then make the case that we should invest in that person building this feature, but it was just their word against the PM's word. And I always listen to the engineers, but some of the PMs don't. And so we feel that by providing this insight to the PMs and the designers and the engineering leadership team, they're now able to see, okay, actually we're doing really badly on our crash rate versus our competitors, and we should actually prioritize that over building this new feature. And the Weather Channel is a great example where they've actually been able to make that case internally as well. Since I/O last year, we've added 50 metrics to the Android Vitals area. So it's a lot of information for developers to consume. And a lot of these are new metrics that didn't exist before, and we've had to come up with a definition for what even these metrics should be. And as a result, there's nearly too much information there for a lot of developers in terms of what to focus on. And so this year at I/O, we introduced the concept of core vitals. These are the main four vitals that we want developers to focus most of their attention on. And they are shown at the top of the Android Vitals section. And there's two for battery and two for stability, and I'll talk about that. But these ones are actually used as part of the ranking in the store. And so these are ones that are most important to actually fix if you have a bad behavior, which is where a bad behavior is defined as if you're in the bottom 25% of apps for using that metric. So this is what that looks like in the Play Console. So if you don't use background wake locks or excessive wake ups, you won't see those metrics. Nearly every app has an or crash events, and so they will see. And if you don't have ANORs and crashes, then either you don't have your app live or you've built the most amazing app ever and I want to see that app, so come show me. For each of the core vitals, we show you what is the percentage of users impacted in the last 30 days for that metric, and then what is the bad behavior threshold for the one that you should target to be less than. If you are above the bad behavior threshold, then we flag that at the top of the section with this card, and then you can click on that to be able to dig into the details to see your performance. On the details page. And on the details page, we break it down, as I mentioned earlier, by APK version. And then you can be able to see both the specific APK that you just launched, 1.4, actually has a much higher percentage of user impact than previous ones. So you probably want to go and debug that issue. Developers have been requesting to be able to be notified when there's a change in their files. So we built anomaly detection. And this is where we show when there's a significant change in any of the core vitals, or there's a significant change in the clusters themselves. And these are flagged at the top of the vital section, with one of these action tiles cards beside a behavior card if you have one. And you can also opt in to receive emails when you actually go above any of these thresholds. And you'll receive an email notification, and from there you can be able to click on an issue and brings it to the specific this is like we have an ANOR cluster, and then you can see where we detected that anomaly in your application. Another major game developer that's been using the Android Vitals section over the last few months with these new features, part of an early access program that they were part of, has seen a decrease in 45% for their crash rate for one of their games that has over 10 million installs. And so We're seeing good results, but we want more developers to adopt it. So hands up here who has an app and has never used Android Vitals. Keep your hand up if you're going to not use it after what you've seen today. Good. Thank you. Hopefully you guys aren't liars. Cool. So now I'm just going to jump quickly into what we think you can do to be able to report Vitals. So the Sebilia area. We have A&R Ridge and Crash Ridge. So as mentioned, A&Rs are when the app stopped responding. And this is where the main thread is blocked. And here are some of the main causes of A&Rs. So network and disk operations being the most common one. And there's a lot of documentation on this to look into it. And we provide insights into what we think is potentially causing your A&R if we have that insight available. And that's an area we're investing a lot in as well to be able to provide better root causing and debugging ambitions. On the crashes side of things, we have some new announcements from I/O this year. So Jetpack is our new libraries for being able to reuse a lot of the code that's available. And it's a more consistent way than we've had in the past for being able to use the ready-to-use components that we have available with backward compatibility. And we advise everyone to be able to use these instead of doing their own implementation. Also, Kotlin, we announced Kotlin support last year at I/O, and we're investing heavily into it now. And it has built-in features that are useful for you in terms of making it so you don't have to worry as much about Sebilia. And finally, we are making improvements in P for how to actually make it so that we restrict access to certain hidden APIs and private APIs. So that is something that we're going to continue with the next version, Android Q, which we're already planning, which is even more than a year nearly out from launch date. But I really encourage you to identify where in your app you're using private APIs or hidden APIs, even potentially through SDKs that you've included in your app, and avoid using them in the future. So on the battery side of things, a stuck wait block is where you prevent the device from powering down the CPU. The stuck part comes in where we flag you when you actually keep a wait block, which is where the device is kept on, for more than an hour. So that's where the stuck comes from. So wait blocks are a feature, and then stuck is the definition that we apply to the wait blocks, where we define it as over an hour. So the best way you can avoid using stuck blocks, stuck wait blocks, is don't use wait blocks at all. So if you must use stuck wait blocks, there's a lot of documentation on how to do it best. And one of the most common issues we see is that developers use the same wait block tag throughout their application in different parts of their application. And so it's really important to use a unique tag when you actually use different wait blocks in your application when you require them, so that we can provide reporting back in the Play Console of the usage of each individual tag. On the excessive wake-up side of things, we encourage you to remove them if possible, reduce the frequency, or replace them with many of the other services we have available. And when you're using these services for job scheduling, they actually offer a lot of things for free that are way better than using wake-ups yourself, including automatic backup and retry. So if we jump into what's available beyond Android Vitals. So Android Studio has a bunch of new profilers available in their latest beta version. And there's a bunch of things, especially related to wait blocks and wake-ups that you can be able to use there for flagging issues with your application. And you can see here, this is the new energy profiler that's available within Android Studio. And you'll see many improvements coming to that over time with better support for Vitals itself. But even as of today, you can use that to be able to get better insights. We also have a full suite of tools available within the Firebase offering if you want to use an SDK in your application. And this is a good point to explain, where does the data for Vitals come from? So when users get a new Android device, there's an option to be able to report your usage data back to Google and our partners. That's where we get the data for the Vitals section, but it's aggregated, so it's there's no PII exposed, of course, and we have it on a platform level basis. So we don't enable developer to actually throw their own exceptions, for example, which other crash reporting tools do if you use an SDK. But other crash reporting tools won't actually get insights into certain things. So if your crash is on startup, then you won't actually see that in an SDK-driven crash reporting tool because the SDK doesn't have enough time to initialize. Whereas that would show up in the Play Console Android Vital section. However, because it's tied to the platform, there's different metrics that we get from different Android versions. So Android Vital only works back to Android 6.0, and even in Android 8.1 and next Android 9, we're going to have more advanced metrics than we've had in any of the other ones. But that means that we only have that data from users who are on that OS version. And so you'll see a lot of difference between each of the Android Vital's metrics themselves. But we're constantly improving the way we collect the data on the devices to make it more actionable and useful for you developers. And so if you want to be able to use tools right now to help you monitor and track the performance of your application, I'd encourage you to also use the Firebase Performance Monitoring Tool, which is a free SDK for you to include in your application. And then you can be able to use counters and a bunch of other tools that they have there to be able to track performance events in your app. We also have Firebase Crash Analytics if you want to be able to do crash reporting in your application. The other major source of information on this stuff is at the documentation app on developers.android.com and the g.co/AndroidVitals. You can see a ton of documentation there on the existing vitals we have, and we keep that updated when we launch new features. And so that's the best place to stay abreast of what's happening and what you can do to be able to improve the performance of your application, even if you don't see data in the vital section. Because you need a sizable number of users using your application for us to be able to provide you insights in a privacy compliant way. Great, thank you very much, everyone. Welcome to the question. So we don't publicize the exact number on that. but I would say it's the majority of users. And so it's enough users to be able to understand the trends in your app performance. And we are getting more and more users to update to the latest version of the OS, which then enables you to be able to get better insights. And we're always working on the updatability of the OS overall, solving that for the problems there. And so you will see a lot more data in the future. So if you don't, let's say, for example, see data in Android files today, I'd encourage you to come back and check on it every few months to see if it's populated. Does that answer your question? Any other questions?
No. If you do think afterwards, like, there will just be around that, like, after the next talk, and yeah, during the break as well. So we're going to have a break now for like 10 minutes while we get started with the next speaker. More beers has now been delivered, so if you want to get another drink, you're welcome to.